What's the difference between an immediate relative visa and a family preference visa? I'm attorney Jonathan Mendoza, and I have helped countless of immigrants with their immigration and criminal defense matters. Now, what's an immediate relative visa? Well, that is a U.S. citizen wanting to apply for residency for their spouse, their minor unmarried child, or a parent. And the biggest benefit of an immediate relative visa is, one, there's no wait time. If you qualify under one of those categories, you can apply for residency right away. And number two, many of the regulations that prohibit you from adjusting status, in other words, obtaining residency here in the United States from beginning to end, don't apply to you. For example, your spouse is working without authorization in the United States, or they're not in lawful status at the time of the application. In contrary, the family preference category or visa applies to really everyone else. You're a lawful permanent resident wanting to apply for a spouse, an unmarried child, you're a U.S. citizen who wants to apply for a brother or sister, or you're a U.S. citizen and you want to apply for a married child or someone over the age of 21 who's a child. Now, the biggest factor in that is that many times, depending on what country you come from, there is a huge wait time. So for example, I have many clients who were petitioned and they were born in Mexico. And I have people come in here where their petition was filed in the 90s. And only now, decades later, are they able to actually apply for their residency. They're able to do it, but unfortunately there are certain countries that have to wait a significant amount of time. Now, it does not mean that you should not petition for your siblings or for your children or spouses. It just means that you have to wait. Now, with that said, the visa bulletin, which is what determines and tells you what visas are available, changes every month. So for example, not too long ago, there was a two-year wait for lawful permanent residences to apply for their spouses. But in July of last year, that changed. And automatically within, that's different, 1 month later, it was current. And you were able to apply for your spouse right away and there was no delay time. So, those are the big differences, but nevertheless, they lead to the same route. The huge difference, of course, is whether you can try to get it now or whether you have to wait later, but the end game is the same. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to answer any questions you may have. This is a complicated area, but happy to help you.